Have you been there? Have you been there sometimes?
Because I was in contact with someone.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I'll get you something. So it's been a couple of weeks, hasn't it?
Aye.
It looks like we're going on to progress town and country.
Yeah.
Did you watch the videos?
No.
What for?
I don't know, I didn't know I had them.
Well, I ticked the boxes. I must have told you in your last lesson to watch the progress town and country. It tells you how to judge all the stealing.
Aye.
And get you some.
I know, quite feel like.
Give you a seat in there first. You are?
I know, like from your theory and that, from practicing that.
Oh, alright. What did the theory tell you then?
So, single.
You got all comfortable?
Real high.
Right, on your driving test, you need to know all the speed limits on the roads.
Yeah.
Because. You can obviously fail for driving too fast and driving too slow.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're driving along the road and it's the street lighting.
Mm-hmm. 30 miles per hour, isn't it?
In built-up area, it's 30 miles an hour. There's two ways, if it's, you can tell if it's a 40.
Yeah.
What's the clues? What do they tell you on your theory?
I don't think I got that question, but
did you know?
Is it just off a sign?
Right, so they call repeat the signs on the lamppost. Have you got that?
Mm-hmm.
Or on poles, so that's to remind you. If you drive along the road, somewhere, 75% of your speed limit's changed at the start of the road you're going into, or the end of the road you're coming out.
Right.
So if you're driving down the road,
mm-hmm.
and you look on the side when you see a 30,
mm-hmm.
what's going to be the speed limit on this road?
Okay.
It's going to be 40.
No, because it's not that road or that road.
That's
right.
Because it's changed. So if you drive down the road and you see no signs in there,
mm-hmm.
that means that speed limit is going to be 30, because you know the housing says it's 30.
Yeah.
So this one's got to be
40.
30.
Oh, 30, right.
So if the speed limit changes from one road to another, so if you drive down the road and you see a 30 sign on the side road, it means this speed limit has changed down to a 30.
Mm-hmm.
So this road would be
40.
Good. Now if you drive down the road and you know these side roads are 30, but there's no signs here, so this speed limit's got to be the same as this one.
Mm-hmm.
What's that one got to be?
40.
30, isn't it? Do you agree?
Uh-huh.
Now, if you're on your driving test and you're sitting doing 30 in a nice, clear 40 road, why is the examiner going to be happy for?
Not going to be happy. Because it's faster.
Well, if you're sitting doing 30 in a nice, clear road and it's 40, what do the drivers behind do?
Overtake, and
that's
there.
Where accidents happen, isn't it?
Yeah.
So on a nice 40 road, you'd be over the moon about 35 miles per hour.
Going clear,
yeah. You don't have to do 40, but 35. We're talking about clear 40s also. If you are doing 30,
mm-hmm.
31, 32 on your driving test on a clear 30 road, guess what the examiner says?
Slow down.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Right. It's hard to sit on the 30, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you get to 33s, 34s.
Yeah.
You get minor errors, and if you do 35 for a period of time,
aye.
Then you... you... going to get a serious fall for that one, yeah?
Uh-huh.
So, you could fail for doing 30 in a 30, why is that?
Because you're going over, and you're going under.
Well, 30 in a 30,
uh-huh.
you could fail because, you know, when the house estate you've run, you know, about 20, you know, when there's loads of parked cars and that.
Uh-huh.
So it's been in 30.
Oh, so like a build-up area.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you haven't been doing that. Now, tell me, what does that sign mean? What does that say mean?
Something about the motorway.
It means national speed limit,
yeah.
Doesn't it? Can I get past it? They just got a car park there, right?
Yeah.
Just go a little bit further forward. That car wasn't there when I just pulled up. Where's that come from?
Yeah,
right, so what does that say mean?
The national speed limit.
Which is?
50 or so. No, 60, yeah.
60 on a single and 70 on a dual. How do you know you're on a dual carriageway?
Well, there's...
Is that a dual carriageway?
No. Yeah, it is, because there's two lanes.
No, that's not a dual carriageway. So that would be a 60 road.
Right.
That's a dual carriageway.
Dual carriageway is where it's got a parking.
Exactly, breaking the strip of land, a raised curb or a barrier, something like that, that would be a dual carriageway. Yeah. Okay. Now bends to the right, keep well to the left as you go around them, and bends to the left, don't be tempted to get to the centre of the road, just keep tight to the left.
Yeah.
If you can't see around a bend, just slow down. We'll have a look at country roads, okay, as well as speed limits. Right, any questions?
No.
Then you're ready. I've taken your temps, you haven't driven for a while, have you?
No.
Right, well, put your window up now, put that aircon on, and look over there, sure. That'll be very delicate with them feet, yours. That's it. And follow the curb around. Now at the end of the road, we're turning left. Now there's no signs we come up here, so what's the speed limit? Still 30. Got to be 30, hasn't it? Do you see any signs at the end of that road?
No.
So you wouldn't do 30 on here, would you?
No.
Because it would be just too fast.
10.
So at the end of the road, we're turning left. Stay around. See how it's national speed limit on that road?
Yeah.
You know when we get there together, who should be the courteous one?
Us.
Us. How did you stop there for me driving now? This road's a 30, how fast should we drive on this one?
25.
Yeah, that's how you want to go, yeah. Because of the, what's the reasons for that?
Long barrier.
And the parked
cars.
Whoever's built up barrier, it's clear, it's still doing 30.
Yeah.
Which mainly because of the parked cars, isn't it? Now just be ready in case anybody comes round the corner. Any speed signs down the bottom?
Yeah, 40.
So all roads off here are now
40.
40. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Good, so we're turning left. Could have just left that, you know. Just don't go for first yet. Stay around and then go for first. What, there's a van coming? Why would you want to go there for?
But he was miles away.
Was he?
Yeah.
Well, he didn't take long to get there, did he? I wouldn't have gone there. See the repeater sign to remind you that's 40? Now, when we get to the end of this road, if there's no signs, it's still going to be
40.
40, good stuff. Now, at the end of the road, we're turning right. And your dormer, I like your middle bit, but use the dormer. You see the 30 signs?
Yeah.
Certain reservation to do. So what, we turn right, you're okay with this? You have your
turn? Yeah.
Good. You know how to position the car?
Yeah,
to the... On this one I want you positioned to the left, look.
Oh right, yeah, because the car's not able to turn around.
Well, that's it. Because it's a lot wider than that one down the bottom. So, keep your car safe. I want you to drive straight in and keep to the left, and if you can't go, I want you to stop down the middle of that grass verge so you know the white car, they can get round you.
Yeah, yeah. Loads of people don't want to go around.
I know, well they should. No, keep it a bit more to the left. Come over to the left more, to my side. Stop down the middle there, stop. So you should have been down the middle so anybody can come round you. that single back one. Good stuff, well done, well done. And then, you know these roads, I'm sure you did.
Yeah.
On your Tesla, so I need to remember. Your clutch is doing what? It's coming up on far too
fast.
Fast. Why do you think that is?
Nerves, really.
You've got nothing to be nervous about, man. Self-isolate, or did you have COVID?
I had to self-isolate. I've had two negative PCR tests and three lab floor negative ones, and I still have to isolate.
Yeah. So,
missed out 10 days of work.
Hmm?
Missed out 10 days of work.
Did you?
Uh-huh.
Is this a dual carriageway?
Yeah.
It is, because it's a raised curb, isn't it? So this one, if it was national speed limit, would be
70.
Good.
But it's 50. Yeah.
It's 60. So it's 50 because the sign said.
Because it's crossing, isn't it?
That's what's the reservation. Going straight ahead at the traffic lights. You've got the choice of lanes. Which one are you going to pick?
Middle left one.
What?
One straight ahead. The one I'm in like now.
Oh, you want the left one.
To go straight ahead?
Yes. Keep left. Sure. So when you've got the choice lanes, which you want to tell you to use? Foot off gas in case they change. So when you have the choice, keep left. Now we're following the signs for Durham.
Yeah.
To the main one. Don't come up the roundabout, it's too fast, it should make hard work for yourself. Put an indicator on. Wait a second. If you put an indicator on, where do you think you're going?
Don't know.
What happened with the clutch there?
It came off into the
way. Why?
Not sure.
Don't know. Now what do we need to do?
Slow down.
No, no, you need to tell people you're leaving.
No.
Why would you want to slow down for?
I don't know, I thought it was give way then. They have to give way.
We were on the ramp, but they've got to get video, haven't they?
This is a good dual carriageway, isn't it?
Yes, and what's the speed limit here? So how fast should we drive on this one?
60.
Good, it's really good. Put that back at 50, you're in 60.
Didn't even want it at 60.
Signs down the bottom in the road marks, I'll tell you what you need to do.
Yeah.
What's that big blue sign telling you down there?
On the right lane.
Good, so what should you be doing?
Okay.
That's it, just get over, it's nice and down. You see the arrows are telling you to move over.
Yeah.
Signal to warn them what you're doing. can't look in that door. Is anybody coming down there? The door mirror. I'll tell the cars behind what you do. I'll look for this solid white line in. It is. So which lane are you going to on the roundabout?
Left.
One left one. Now if there's no signs as we come down here, what's the speed limit all over? Just pass the sign, sorry.
30.
40.
40.
And the last time we moved off, you pulled that clutch up really quick. So I just want to do it a little gas, nice and smooth. Whoa, it feels like you've been stalled, isn't it? Yeah, you're lifting off it very quickly. Now keep to the left as you go around. Because on that other roundabout you tried to go to the right lane, didn't you? So you keep to the left. But go on, straight again. Watch for people overtaking. And your door mirror. Now you should be slowing down a bit. It's a little bit on the fast side. But it looks like you're trying to stall. Don't rush the clutch when you move off. Just take your time and hold it as you move off. You have the choice lanes to go straight ahead?
Left.
Well, check behind you. No, yeah, left. Why did you?
I thought it was roll works.
What? Stop breaking. What?
I thought it was roll works blocking it off.
Put the clutch down. Leave the gears and focus on the smoke stop. Yes, but when you've got the choice of lanes, you keep to there. To the left, I don't know. Put it in Euro. And just take your time. You're driving far too fast, too aggressive. Do you understand how you're going to move off here? Don't rush. You're frightening the life out of me. Take your time. Now this road, what's the speed limit on here?
30.
40, past the signs about there. Not that you would do 40, how fast should we go along here?
About 30.
Yeah, that's all you want, 30. Now where's Crook? We're going for Crook.
Straight on.
Yes, I would do what you were going to do there. I would have dropped that in the second gear. Not now.
Yeah.
What gear are you going to go over the roundabout in?
Second.
You need to slow down a bit. It's too fast. Signs for Crook. Don't go to third. Read the signs first. Where's Crook at? Look at the road markings. Keep the junctions clear on your left. Did you see the junctions?
Yeah.
So it's keep them clear. Clutch is still coming up too quickly. So do you know which exit we're taking?
Yeah, third.
Foot's come up really quick. That's better. That's much better. Keep doing it like that. Where are you going?
Just go to the right exit.
Yeah.
Oh.
The Crook was that way, wasn't it?
Yeah, should I go left here?
Yeah, go on. Just go straight up. We'll have to go. Said Crook was straight ahead, didn't it?
Yeah, I thought it was the third exit.
It was. Well, the second one's not an exit, but it's still it's classed as one.
Oh, right.
But did that not feel right to you going that way? Did that not feel like you were turning right the way you just got? them signs on the left hand side.
It's 20.
Foot off gas. Maybe just keep it at 20, keep away from the van. Just left the centre up here and we'll come all the way back round the roundabout. So you've got to give way to the right up here. Just keep it to the centre line. Come over to the right side now. Up to the right lane and have a look and see if you can go. Have a look.
Yeah.
Now go to the right lane on the roundabout. Then we turn right and come all the way back round. We're going to come back down there and retrace our steps and we're turning right. Install Rocco, we need to hold that clutch as you're moving off. Do number four, that one's number two. Which lane are you supposed to leave in? Oh, you're in the right. Well, just keep in the right because there's road works down here. But you didn't know that, did you? So when you leave the roundabout and you've got two lanes clear, which lane do you leave in?
The
left one, good. What made you want to leave in the right then?
I don't know, I just thought that white car then.
What?
I thought the white car was like right behind us.
Alright. Well, if you know, if it's getting really big in the door, that, what does that mean?
That's a bigger problem.
It's too close, isn't it? Whether it wasn't big in the door. This is time we're turning right there next time. Got your clutch down, got your clutch down. Now keep your tyres on top. And then what should we do to keep the car safe? Now this roundabout's controlled by traffic lights. Turn right. Look at the road markings at the top of this lane you need. What colour's your light on?
Oh, right.
Good. And what colour's the next one on?
Red.
See that red car though? Mm-hmm. Where are you going where that red car's going? Right. Do you understand where you're going? Now will you please bring the clutch up slowly and hold it as you move on. Please, I'm begging you. Don't chuck it up quickly. Where's your backup light?
Why do they have them shutters on us?
Just to stop other people from seeing it, other cars staying there. Want your left door mirror. The sign says we need the right lane. So use your mirrors and go to the right lane. Now we're straight ahead from here though.
Straight
on. We're straight over there, isn't it?
Aye.
Which way is that? So do you understand where you're going?
Aye.
Please bring your clutch up slowly and hold it as you move off.
Should I have an indicator, bro?
You're going straight ahead, aren't you? So you don't signal when you're going straight ahead. Mm-hmm. I remember it's a downhill start. Don't rush, just take your time. See, the bus driver, people.
Yeah.
It's shocking, that. Mm-hmm. You must think to learn a driver's route like that, like experienced drivers. But the good driver makes allowances for other people's mistakes. If I wasn't on video, I know what I'd like to see. Your hill starts like?
Yeah, alright.
Good. Famous last words.
Cast to a cast.
Good. And don't throw the clutch over anything. Do it nice and smooth. Junctions clear on the left. We're going right at the traffic lights. Second lane. Now this one is just a bend, so you just go straight around to the right. Do you watch the football?
Yeah, aye.
What do you think?
I haven't played well, but
painful.
There's nothing you can do about it like now.
Where do you watch it at home?
I think.
You think we're going to win?
Yeah, I had bets on, didn't I?
Didn't bet on England, did you?
Yeah, we
are.
I won the first bet, like.
What was that? Take
draw,
your time
in full time.
Tell people where you're going.
That's straight around.
It is. Just a bend. Now this road, what do you think the speed limit is on this road?
30, 40.
30. If you've seen 40, if you think 40, you've got to have seen a sign.
Yeah.
So where there's regular street light,
just 30.
It's a little bit stern. Now do you see the flashing lights on the left hand side?
Yeah, it's 20 because it's
small. Them's an advisory.
So you don't have to do that yet until you get.
So I would just take your foot off the gas and just go down to the 20 for us, because I think, I'm not sure what time the school's come out.
About this time.
Is it?
Yeah, it's normally about 3:30. Let's drop that one second.
Yeah, I would. Look how much we're giving these parked cars. That lollipop you've got to stop, haven't you? Mission. Come on, keep the left. Why are you going to go onto the right lane for?
I thought we would have made turn.
You what?
I thought we would have made turn. Right.
Now you know if I don't give instruction at traffic lights, where do you go straight?
Right.
It in your room, so I want you to keep to the left at all times unless you're directed by signs and markings, or I'll ask you to turn what you will do some good time or you're overtaken. So otherwise just keep this car to the left. your middle mirror stalk here. Lower that, isn't it? No, this is a downhill start, so please be gentle with that clutch. Put a big gas on before you do the clutch. Is 35 fine, so what do you do?
Keep your foot on, press the
button. You went up to 40 miles an hour, how do you work that out? Yeah, I need to seek help. So on this road it's safe to do 30, isn't it, because it's nice and clear? So you'd be expected to do the speed limit on this road, because it's nice and clear, there's no hazards. This feels really good for a really comfortable speed. Just in case somebody opens the door, car moves off, or
someone crosses out. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly right. Now see how it opens up now. Dodge that curb, Rocco. So now you check your mirrors and just get up to 30 if it's safe to do so. But don't go over the 30. Slow before put the gas on first. So you see that the lollipop? You know that black line?
Yeah.
You've got a foot off gas. It's quite hectic. It's got chalk in a pocket. Now if you don't stop, you write your registration on that long, that long black line.
Aye.
And report you to the police. Now again, mirrors, and it's safe to do 30 now, isn't it? But it wasn't back there, was it? There's one.
It's built up.
And this is built up. It wasn't safe to do 30 because there's lots of street furniture, like parked cars and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Is anybody at the crossing?
No.
We went to Sunday last time, didn't we? Did you watch the video?
Oh, my video, aye.
Well, you went the wrong way.
Uh-huh.
You told it, don't you?
I know, it's just,
over there or not?
Do you store I don't want to say anything, I don't think so. But
did you know?
I don't think so.
Oh, you've done well. Because normally they'll store loads over there. Signs you see up ahead. Good. Now when you get to there, you need to look in the mirrors to see if anybody's overtaking you, because like people like overtake. Is nobody overtaking? Right, how fast should you drive along this road?
About 50.
Yeah, about 45, 50, go for it. Because it's quite wide, you can see further up the road, can't you? Say try your next gear, but don't rush it. Good, well done, that's good. So yeah, if you want about the 50 along here. The learners will come up here on the test and drive at 30 miles an hour. Then everybody will start overtaking with it. See why you use your mirrors for long? So they're doing more than 60, aren't they? So they're doing about 70, aren't they? See why you use your mirrors up?
Yeah.
People overtake like that. Now when you get round this bend, look down the left and right hand sides of the road and tell me what signs you see. Even if it was a 60, you wouldn't do a 60 through here, would you?
No.
That one again, see it changing, so you want a mirror check if anybody will take it. dragging the life out of the ghillie, and you need to take it tightly. Now your speed feels alright here because it's nice and clear, isn't it? So 30's good here. This bend, we're going to take the next left. See it? Put your mirrors first. Slow down with the brake, and then change down. That's it. Watch out the road. Don't go on the gas and follow the curb round. Now see, follow the curb round. Have you seen the national speed limit as we come in? See how it opens up a little bit?
Yeah.
So you need a mirror check and then accelerate a bit more. It's flying, isn't it?
Oh,
see how it opens up?
Yeah.
Now when the road opens up, you check your mirrors and accelerate, yeah. But the road closes in.
Start slowing down.
You start exactly checking and slow down. Now do not forget this bend. This is a hot spot on your driving test course. If you can't be really test, you need safety for this bend. Keep your gas on. Now we're not going to brake for it, we're just going to go for the gear and see when you get it. So don't brake for this because you won't. Keep your gas on. give you a bit more control, a bit more steerability in the car. What signs you see ahead? See the 30s in the side road. Cancel the signal. Rocco, you'll get me shot. What happened at the roundabout?
I didn't look.
You didn't look? I only come to roundabout and not look.
I don't know.
Well, it's funny enough, I'm just pointing, I haven't got a picture of that one, but I see a lot of lands do that. But when you come round, you've got to look to the right, haven't you? Go on, off you go. Make sure you look right at these roundabouts. So, repeat the signs, should you remind you that it's 40, or how fast should we drive on this road?
35.
Yeah. Go on, straight again. Now, if you look in the side road, can you see 30s in there?
Yeah.
So that means you're on a
30,
40. Now, expect the lights to change. Mirrors. A foot off gas. See, don't accelerate or go through the lights. You've got to take your foot off and be ready to stop. That's what they do in Thailand. They accelerate when they see the amber because they know it's going to change. Can I just leave it up to you to see if you drive too fast or too slow?
Yes.
Would that be alright? So what happens on this next country road? Just take foot off the gas. And what happens on this country road is you lot drive too fast.
Or too slow.
Yes, you drive too fast when you should be driving slow, and you drive too slow when you should be driving a bit faster. So let's see how you deal with it. So you're happy to do it on your own, yeah? Traffic lights were turning left. Now, I wouldn't indicate yet because it's far too early, isn't it?
It's parked,
lad. It's parked. Go around it. Clutch. garage. We're not going to stop you having podcasts, are we?
Yeah, no.
How could you tell it was parked?
Yeah, it had no lights on.
And there's nobody in the car, was there?
No.
And it was right next to the curb, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So it was in a queue of traffic, it'd be in the middle of the road, wouldn't it? Take your foot off the gas because this is quite tight. Don't go on the gas. beach as you go down that. Yeah, I would have done that before the bend.
Yeah.
Just give it more control. At the end of the road, turn right. Speed wasn't too bad, it's just that little bit of a hill that you're going on. Just your road positioning, straight of gears. Just take your time, you're mapping the curb, and you got a bit too close again. So, just foot off, guys. What's your road positioning link do?
Just fall to the right.
No, what's your road positioning link do? Your eyes.
Oh, right.
So, you're looking in the wrong places. If you're going to mount the curb, you're not looking where the car's going. So you must have been doing a little bit of staring.
Yeah.
Other than that, it was fine. Just a little bit slow up the hill, but nothing to write home about.
Well, yeah, I forgot to say how long we're doing a day, an hour and a half.
Yeah. Well, if it was an hour, it would have been back ages ago.
Alright.
Thank you. schools has gone now, haven't they? Stop and then lean the top half of your body forward. So there, we didn't need any brake, you just need to put it in third gear.
Yeah.
Now you're going to find yourself on the wrong side of the road a bit, so make sure nobody's overtaken and be ready to pull in if a car comes. Now what gear do you think you should put in?
Second.
Good. Don't have to brake because you're going slow enough. Now learn to come up here and fly up here.
Really?
Yeah. You've got to be ready. If the van comes, just pull in on the left. Pull in on the left here. That's it. Don't get any closer to the white car. What weight? Stop. 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 What gear do you need?
First.
Now be ready. Be ready to nip in again if a car comes. So you expect to look for passing places. Don't go any faster, this is as fast as you want to go. And then at the end of the road, we're turning right.
Just back off a bit, just back.
Yeah, you can get around that. I think it's enough room there.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, just go around. Miss second out, we'll go to third gear. Just go down and up. Now, did you see the national speed limit? No, we'll just ignore that. I wouldn't go any faster. Don't go any faster. This is too fast. Look at the road, it's going downhill. It's back into here. Yeah. Don't go on the gas, you need your foot on the brake all the way down. Feels a bit faster to go around this bend. I don't know why they've changed this to 64. You need to be on the brake all the way down here. See the national speed limit?
Yeah.
Why are they reminded of that? I don't understand. Look at the warning signs. What's the warning signs telling you?
Cyclists and pedestrians.
Right, now there's another sign here that tells you it's road narrows on both sides.
Yeah.
See the bus stopping at the other side?
Yeah.
So why have they put this road at 64?
Tunnel.
I think the bus is waiting, isn't it? When you stop, what gear you got to get?
First.
Just wait a second. Give them a wave.
Just sat there, didn't he? Joking out.
See, I have to change it back to 30 now. So that little piece of road, to put it to 60. I don't know why. But you were going a bit faster.
Yeah.
It was going downhill and it should have been slowed down. Footwork's letting you down. Just take your time. You've got to be gentle with the pedals when you're just throwing the clutches up. You've got to take your time. And remember, hill, don't go in a third, just keep in second. When you do a hillside, you've got to feel a slight tug on the car, haven't you?
Wow.
Are you just rushing? End of the road, we're turning right now. Just take your time up at this junction, don't rush. Stop with the brake, don't you? Don't stop with the handbrake. Put your handbrake on now, properly. Right, put it to the gas. Put it in neutral. Now, just relax a minute. Now, you know you've got to hold your clutch when you move off. You're just bringing the clutch up far too quickly. Put it in the first, try again. Now, don't we just do a little gas in the tuck for us. No, not like that. I'm not worried about that. Just do a little gas in the tub for it. Not too quick, Rocco. That's enough. Right now, get a gas in the tub now. Hold the clutch still. Just because he's letting you out doesn't mean you've got to go, does it? What was coming from your right? But your footwork, Rocco, it's letting you down. You're coming off the clutch really quick. Why do you think you're doing that for?
I'm not sure.
Straight there. You've just got to take your time with your footwork. Yeah, just because the flies doesn't mean you just go. What have you got to do first?
Stop.
No, you haven't got to stop. What have you got to do?
Oh, get a tug.
No, before that.
I don't know what you're saying.
Right, foot off the gas. When somebody flashes you from the light, from the left, you've got to check and see if it's in front of you.
Aye.
What happens if there's somebody coming from your right? You'll crash into it, you just pull out, won't you?
Aye.
So your foot just come up really, really quickly. You just can't do it. Give us a bit more room. That's it. I'll be ready in case they wake up. Slowing down your speed up again. You've got parked cars on the left, parked cars on the right. Use your brake to move off. You want your foot on the brake all the way down here. You don't want any gas on. Keep the speed under control. Slow down and go in a second. If a bus comes or a large vehicle, I would. What would you do?
Stop.
Good. Slow. So at the traffic lights we're turning left. for that handbrake, just put your clutch down. Don't go for the handbrake. Put it stop. Stop. Put it into first gear. That's reverse. Put your handbrake on. Right, and it gives a hill start. So you were going to try and pull out there in third gear.
Yeah.
What would have happened?
Yeah, I would have just
straight in second. What, sorry?
We rolled back or something because I wasn't going too fast.
No. You were going to try and pull off in third. What would have happened to the car on a hill?
Stall.
Would have stalled, wouldn't it? And then you went and forced it, and I did see you ragging the gears. What happened? What gear did you go to?
Reverse. And then what the car behind?
Just got to take your time. But it was sod's law, what did the lights do just as we were stopping?
To go green.
So on that scenario, you'd just be expected to stop, put in the first, put your handbrake on. That's what you have to do. It's a steep hill, isn't it? this next piece of road is absolutely dreadful. Do you know which one I mean? It's really bad, so. This is as fast as you want to go here because of the bends in that. I know it's a national speed limit, but it feels like it's as fast as you want to go. This road shouldn't be a 60 either, it should just be a 30.
Well, how could you get up the hill, isn't it?
You what, sorry?
How could you get up the hill in 30?
You could easily do 30, couldn't you? There's a stables back there, isn't there?
Yeah.
Horses, you get a lot of horses. Road's quite narrow. I think they're just trying to keep all the roads uniform. All the country roads the same speed limit.
Yeah.
There's no way you won't be doing anywhere near the national speed limit on this road.
this was closed down here.
Is it? It's full of gas, but there's a bit of rain. Been closed off those hips before, isn't it? Dirty area, it's like a hole.
Eh?
Dirty area. It's close.
It used to be worse, didn't it?
See the difference here? Just pull up on the left for a bit to get around the corner. Where's your car at?
Yeah, mum's on.
Just pull it in, next to the car. Your mum's got it? Stop there. Right, how do you think you've done the deer?
Rubbish.
Oh, Rocco, what are we going to do with you? Right, what's letting you down?
Probably be pedal work.
Why do you think that is?
Being too rough for us.
I know, but why?
Eh? I don't know.
You don't know.
I just think just been a bit too long.
Well, it has, that's probably the reason why. When pupils miss a lesson, it tends to go back a little bit. But just there when you pull out into the junction, gas, clutch up and hold, and then perfect. And then the next one just gas and clutch right up. Did you get nervous or what?
I don't know what it is, I don't know.
And you're rugging the life out of the gears levers, and you went in there, when the taxi flashed you. You went, oh, was it? I can't remember, but you shook. Okay, you've got to get reverse. So you just need to take your time, but I know where you're going back next week, that the uphill junction.
Oh, right, yeah.
In the traffic lights, because you flapped a little bit
Nevels
there.
Cross, didn't you? Yeah.
Well, look, but that's not as because it's forgetting the name of it.
Cross gears.
That's I'm forgetting. You're probably right. But yeah, just your footwork's letting you down a bit. And sometimes you're staring a bit too much.
I think that's just zoning out.
You need to keep look at the needers since middle and fall.
Yeah.
Right, national speed limit on a single carriageway road, what's that?
60.
What's it on a dual carriageway road?
70, sorry.
How do you know you're on a dual carriageway?
It's got a verge, a central verge.
Good, a raised barrier. If you roll a football across stops in the middle, you know it's a dual carriageway. Uh-huh. If you're driving along the road and you see 30 signs in the side road, what's the speed limit on here?
40.
40. And you're not expected to do 40, are you? I don't know why that starts itself again. Right, have you any questions before you go?
No, not really.
Can you see the Thursday next week?
Thursday, aye. Right. Anytime.
Are you off, mate?
No, I'm off. She's just changed me rota. Instead of being in, she said I could be in on the Thursday. No, I could be in on the Thursday and have Wednesday off. And then she said, oh, I need you in on the Wednesday because we short staffed.
So you have the Thursday off?
Thursday all day, aye.
Right, I'll send you a text, okay? But we're going to have a look back over that way next week.
Thanks very much.
That's on your test room here.
Sorry, you're down with me footwork.
Oh, I don't worry about it. I'll see you next week. I'll text you with time, okay? You didn't bring anything else, did you?
No.
Sure?
No, positive.
Fetch your slippers next week.
I will.
See you later.
See you later. Bye-bye.